Hi, this post is way overdue, but I thought I would step out and just post a little recording. I wanted to let you know what I've decided to do. I have had a lot of prayer, discernment, and reading through your guys' comments that yes, I'm going to persevere. This is in regards to the post that my son had posted on his social media, and then I posted on August 5th. Kind of some challenging questions and some frustrations that I was having on my side. I guess not frustrations, but more questions and doubt. And I want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Your encouragement, your words, and your prayers. I am so incredibly grateful for all of you, and it means a lot to me. So thank you for taking the time to read my post and make a comment. And thank you for your words of encouragement. I have decided I'm going to keep pursuing justice. And I have actually, just about the time that I posted that comment on August 5th, I was just wrapping up a tort notice, which is a lawsuit notice. And I'm not surprised the timing on it. The enemy was coming against me. But I have made notice. I have mailed my notice to Deschutes County of Bend, Oregon, as well as 13 judges who were involved, as well as the City of Bend, the Oregon Department of Justice, and some other entities. I have filed my notice and given it to them, letting them know that I am going to be taking them to court. I'm either taking them to federal court because of diversified jurisdiction, it allows me to do that, or I will file in state court. I haven't decided yet. I will pray into that of where the Lord wants me to take it. But there are three things that they have done unlawfully, and I've decided I'm gonna get in the place of offense. I'm no longer gonna be living from a place of defense, and I'm gonna stand up for what they've done. I'm sure I'm not the only victim. So I have sent out a notice letting them know that I'm gonna go ahead and file a complaint. It's a lawsuit against them. There were three things. One, they didn't have jurisdiction to make a custody order or even do all the things they did. They signed, there were 54 orders, meaning there, and many of those, probably 40 of them, might have been me requesting visitation with my children that they had denied. So they had signed orders that were outside of their jurisdiction. And what I mean by that is Brian moved to the state of Washington in July of 2020. 6 months from that date, Washington became my children's new home state. They no longer had connection with the state of Oregon. They no longer had connection with me. And so the state of Oregon didn't have jurisdiction over me, over my children, or over my ex-husband. And so everything that they had done, which I believe it was 13 different judges, including the 54 orders that were signed from the 6 months, which was around January of 2021, that they didn't have any jurisdiction. All those orders were signed without jurisdiction, which actually removes their immunity. So they used to be able to say, hey, we're immune, you can't sue us, because they're is a kind of a protection over judges, law enforcement. But if they step outside of their authority and they do things that is not within their job capacity, then they are liable for suit. And that is what has happened here. It was all the Holy Spirit that revealed this to me, and law school. So I'm super grateful for law school. It's been such a blessing to learn the things that I have. And so I'm suing for jurisdiction. They also violated a ADA, American Disability Act. So in February of this last year, I hired a ADA advocate who helps in family court for the stress, the anxiety, the mental disability, the anxiety. There's so much anxiety and sometimes even fear, if I was to be honest, when you go into a court hearing against these justices who are, they're not fair. And it is supposed to be non-biased, and that's not how it is. So it's very frustrating, and it can be fearful. So I hired this AD advocate. Her name's Francesca Amato. She had posted a comment on my post, by the way, for any other moms who are looking for an advocate. Anyway, so I had hired her in February and of this year, and the judge would not allow her to advocate for me. And that's a violation of the ADA. It would be like taking a wheelchair away from somebody in court who needed a wheelchair. The judge was so disrespectful. So they violated that, which again, they don't have immunity when they do, when they violate something that horrendous. And then the third thing, I don't feel at liberty to share yet what it is that they've done. But I'm sure at some point I will, but it is actually pretty horrendous, kind of a heinous, I would say, act that the courthouse and the judges have done to create a lot of anxiety and fear in me by something they had done with regarding interstate commerce and mailing some stuff across state line that they unlawfully did. And in my opinion, I think they intentionally did it. And so that is also in the suit. Those are the three top things that I am taking them to federal court, federal or state court, depending on what the Lord shows me. But I will be pursuing justice. And they've got to stop what they're doing. It was by God's intervention that these three things were shown to me and revealed to me. So I just want to say thank you so much for all of your guys' help, for your words of affirmation. It was confirmation to my spirit. It was very troubling at first, and I wasn't sure what I should do, but I believe this is right. My kids would want me to, and you're right. Somebody had made a comment about no kid will ever say, oh, I wish you wouldn't have fought for me. That's not true, and at some point, my kids are going to be adults. I pray this doesn't go that long, but at some point, they're going to be adults, and there is no amount of brainwashing or mind control or programming that can get past the Holy Spirit. My kids are spirit-filled. They love the Lord. They love Jesus. And regardless of what this satanic group does to my kids, it's all going to be broken off. And I actually am declaring and decreeing that it's already broken off of them. And that this is, they have to do it for survival. So, Warren, Clara, if you guys are watching, I love you guys so much. I miss you so much. And I will not stop fighting for justice for you guys. I won't. And Warren, if you wholeheartedly believe what you believe now, I know that someday the Holy Spirit is going to get a hold of you and show you the truth, but I'm actually believing that you already know the truth. So I just want you to know that. I love you guys. I love you, Clara. Your birthday is like less than 2 weeks away on September 11th. Well, I guess that maybe it's 3 weeks. And, my heart aches to think another birthday without you, Warren. Too many years have gone by, and to miss your birthday as well is just heartbreaking. But I love you guys. I will always love you. And there's nothing that will ever separate my love from you. Nothing you say, nothing you do can ever hurt me. Nothing. Because I know your guys' intentions. I know your true heart. So I love you guys. Thank you all for your prayers And I'm just praying for the best. All right. Thank you guys. Bye.